फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। सी बेटा, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टुडे इज अर्थ डे एंड विशेस टू यू ऑल फॉर द अर्थ डे। एंड सी बेटा, फॉर क्लास 10 इन आवर अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस चैप्टर 5 एक्सरसाइज 5.1 कंप्लीटली। ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 5.2 एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक। एंड सी बेटा, इन दिस लेक्चर माय मोटो इज टू कंप्लीट एटलीस्ट 4-5 सम्स, बिकॉज ऑल द सम्स ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज कंटेनिंग सो मच पार्ट्स। ओके, सो आई विल बी लिटिल बिट फास्टर। वन सेकेंड थिंग, because the questions are very simple, we have derived the relation of general term yesterday in the last lecture. You all have seen that. If you have not seen, you have to see that first, because of that you will be able to understand the concept of general term or nth term of the AP. okay, now without any delay we are going to start exercise 5.2 question number 1. See beta, I am writing the relation here. The nth term of an AP is A plus N minus 1D. This is first term, common difference. Any term you want to find, put N here, and here you will find the desirable result. See beta, in the last lecture, at the last I said 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 variable quantities are there, and out of these 4, 3 are known. Then you can very easily find the fourth quantity. And question number 1, exercise 5.2, is totally dependent on this relation. Okay, without any delay, I am going to start question number 1 part first. See beta, what is given here? A is 7, D is 3, N is 8, find AN. A and we have to find in this question. Okay, see beta, what is the formula for an? A plus N minus 1D, yes or no? A plus N minus 1 into D. What is an? We have to find, put the value of N, it will be A8, yes or no? A is 7, N is 8, D is 3. See beta, A is 7, N is 8, D is 3. We just put the values in the relation. And what will we get from here? A8 is equal to 7 plus, what is this? 7 into 3. From here, A8 is 7 plus 21. See beta, Bodmas rule. Multiplication should be done first, okay? What will you get? 28 is the answer. 28 was the answer. See beta, these are very simple questions. Each and every part of a first question is very simple. You have to just take it, understand the concept and put the values. Surely you will get the desirable result. Okay, done. Now next question, question number 1 part 2. See how many 6 parts are given. Na? 6 parts are given. 3 I am solving, 3 you have to solve by yourself. Okay, if you find and fail, you can discuss with me. Okay, now see, question number 1 part, 6 part are there, now 1, 3, 5 I am doing, 1st, 3rd and 5th I am doing, and the even parts you have to do. Okay, first question, third part, because I am skipping these 1-2 parts for you, because this is very simple. See beta, third part, A is not given, D is given minus 3, N is given 18, and AN is given minus 5. So simple, out of 4 variables, 3 are known. You can very easily find the fourth, yes or no? Very easily you can find the fourth variable. See beta, what is the rule? An is equal to A plus N minus 1D, yes or no? This is the rule. Put the values, n is minus 5, a is unknown, n is 18, and d is minus 3. Okay, see beta, these are very simple substitution type of questions. We are just putting the values and getting the values. Okay, now see, minus 5, a plus, this is 17 and this is minus 3. Yes or no? Done beta. Minus 5 is equal to a plus minus minus, am I right? Done beta. Now see, a is equal to, or you want to keep a is here, it will be minus 5 is here, shift this toward it, it will be 51 plus. Okay, therefore a is equal to 46 answers. A is equal to 46 answers. See beta, if any calculation problem is there, you have to check by yourself, because these are very simple calculation and I am just doing these very fastly. Okay, you are in 10th class, calculation part is of yours. Okay, now see, a d n and a n is equal to a plus n minus 1 d, a n is minus 5, we put here, a was unknown, 18 minus 1, d was minus 3. 17 into minus 1, it will be minus 51. When you shift minus 51 towards this side, it will be plus 51. 51 minus 5, 46 is the answer. Done beta, take the screenshot. We are going to solve question number 1 part, 5th now. 3rd you have done, now we will do 5th part, because even parts are I have left for you. You have to do by yourself, and surely after watching these 3 questions you will not have any doubt. I make you believe that, but you have to focus. 5th part, see beta, a is given 3.5, d is given 0, oh ho, n is 105, what is a n? You can guess when d is 0, plus d plus d plus d plus d plus d, all the terms are same. I have given you this example in the introductory lecture. See, a n is equal to a plus n minus 1 d, yes or no? Done beta. Now see, a n you have to find, n is 105, a is 3.5, 105 minus 1 n to 0, all the terms are same. When d is 0, yes or no? All the terms are same when d is 0. Okay beta, these 3 parts I have done, and the remaining 3 parts you have to do by yourself. Still any difficulty, you can talk to me. Okay, you can contact me. Done. You have taken the screenshot. Now see beta, question number 2. Question number 2. What is the question number 2 here given? Very, very simple and very easy questions beta. Now your speed, calculating speed will matter in how many time can you perform such kind of simple questions. See beta, here very simple calculations are and very simple formula is there. Question number 2 part 1st. See what is asked here. You are given an AP 10, 7, 4 and so on, and you have to find its 30th term. You have to find its 30th term. See beta, what is the terminology in this? First term is 10. Whenever you are solving the any question of AP, write the all parameters here, quantities here, so those will help you for the final, for the process. Okay, and d is equal to this minus this minus 3, yes or no? Done. What is asked here? A 30, 30th term, what it will be? Now see beta, if it is numeral, and if you have seen the earlier lecture, what I have said, whichever term you have to find less than that times d will be added to first term. Okay, see, here we have to find a 30. I am writing this A30 directly as A plus 29D. Why? See beta, formula is A plus N minus 1D. A plus N is 30 minus 1D, because this term we have to find A plus 29D. You should be habitual of directly putting these values when this is numeral. It will be very helpful in your next questions. Okay, beta, try to make it your habit that A plus 1 times less. It was 30, 30 minus 1, 29 times D will be added to the A. Okay, now see what is A, 10. 29, D is minus 3. 10 plus minus minus 87 will you get? Minus 77 is the answer. Minus 77 is the answer. See beta, it was so simple. We just put the values obtained from the given information in the formula and find the solution. Then you can take the solution screenshot beta and see what is the answer. Answer C. Okay. Now see question number 2, part 2nd. What is part here? What is asked here? Sorry. We have to find the 11th term of the AP minus 3, minus 1 by 2, 2 and so on. This is the statement beta, and we have to find 11th term. We have to find 11th term here. Okay, see. What is the information? A is minus 3. Okay, and D is this minus this. See beta, now you have to take care of the signs. Minus 1 by 2, minus minus 3. This term minus this term. This term minus this term. Minus half plus 3. You will get 5 by 2. 3 minus half. 3 minus half. 5 by 2, 2.5. Okay. Now see. What you have asked? A11. A11. Go for the direct. See beta. Direct rule I have said. 1 less than this times D will be added to A. Okay. You will get A is minus 3. D is 5 by 2. Yes or no? Sorry, it was 10, na? It was 10. 2 5s are. What it will be? Minus 3 plus 25. Answer is 22. Yes or no? Is there any option 22? See the calculation. Is there any calculation? 20, okay, 22. B. Option B is the answer. Okay, beta. Option B is the answer. Take the screenshot. It was so simple. Next. Question number 3 we are going to solve right now. Question number 3 is, see beta, here some boxes are given and you have to fill the box. See beta, now I will like to make you little bit more practical about the AP concept. See one thing, see beta. A, B, C are in AP. It is given that A, B, C are in AP. Whenever three numbers are in AP, always remember what will happen. See, this minus this will be equal to this minus this. Yes or no? B minus A is C minus B. Done. Now see what happens. Here is B. Move this toward this. Here is C. Send this towards right. 2B is equal to C plus A or A plus C. What does it mean? Whenever three numbers are in AP, these things you have to keep in your mind, beta. Whenever the three numbers are in AP, double of middle one is sum of sides. Sum of side ones. Okay. double of the second will be sum of first and third. Directly you can use this result. Okay, sum of first and third will give you double of second. This is the same kind question number 3 part first. See, in question number 3 some boxes are given and values are asked. You can do by these two methods. See, 2 box and then 26. Okay, now according to my method, suppose this is x. According to my method, these three are forming AP. Okay, here it is given. Na? If the given are APs, then fill the boxes. Okay, these all are APs. 1, 2, 3. Three numbers are only given. It means these are in AP. It is given. These are in AP. What does it mean? Double of middle one, sum of first and third. Double of middle one, we have discussed here. Sum of first and third. From here, 2x is equal to 28, x is equal to 14. Yes or no? Done, beta? Okay. Double of middle one is equal to sum of first and last. Done? Sure? Okay. Now, next question. Slowly, you will all get command on the APC, beta. This is the lecture will make your foundation. You have to be very, very serious about this lecture and very, very confident and effective. Okay, your efficiency should be very good in this lecture. Dash, comma 13. Dash, comma 3. See, beta, now I will make you learn this type of questions with the criteria which is very, very, very helpful and which will be applicable in next sums. See, beta, what is given here in this question, in this type? Suppose, what is this? This is first term and this is third term. Yes or no? First term and third term we have to find. See, beta, second term is given. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth term is also given. Yes or no? Second term is given. Fourth term is given. And what is second term? When D is the common difference, what is second term? A plus D. Yes or no? Done, beta. 2, 1 less than this. Time D will be added to A. In the same way, what it will be? A plus 3D is equal to 3. You got my point? Yes or no? 1 less than this times D will be added to A. A plus 3D is 3. Now see, beta, you have two equations. One is A plus 3D and one is A plus D. Now if you subtract, this is cancelled, yes or no? 3D minus D, 2D. 3 minus 13, minus 10. Whatever is the value of D, D is minus 5. D is minus 5. What does it mean? From here, minus 5 was subtracted. It means this is 8. Yes or no? And from here, minus 5 was subtracted. You can see, beta, when you reverse NAP, D signs in changed. We got D minus 5 means this minus 5, this minus 5, this minus 5. If you start writing from there, you will write 3 plus 8, 3 minus 8, 5 was not, 3 plus 5, 8 plus 5, 13 plus 5, you will get 18, yes or no. Okay, this is the one method. Otherwise, you will use this method. See, beta, here you can put this. A plus D is 13. Value of D is minus 5. A plus minus 5, A minus 5. Yes or no? From here is 13. Put this like this. A is 18. Yes or no? And this is 8 minus 5, 13 minus 5, this minus 5. Satisfied? Yes or no? Take the screenshot, beta friends. Once you take the screenshot, it was very simple. Okay? See, we converted this into this form. Why I converted? It was, there are one, two methods more which will help you to make this, to solve this some simpler method, simpler way, in a simpler way. But no, I use this method because I want to make your foundation for the next upcoming sums. Okay? So try to think in this way. This will surely help you to deal every kind of questions in a simplest way. Okay? Done. Now see beta, question number next. Question number next. Take the screenshot. See. What is the third part? In third part, 5, comma box, comma box, comma is 9, 1 by 9, whole 1 by 2. Okay, see what is given here. (5, (9)) = 1/2, 9 whole (1/2). See, (1, 2, 3, 4). See, beta, first term is 5, and fourth term is 19/2. Yes or no? First term is 5, fourth term is 19/2. From here, can I write? (a + 3d) = 19/2, yes or no? (a + 3d) = 19/2. From here, see beta, what is 5 + 3d = 19/2. Now see, 3d = 19/2 - 5. 3d = 19/2 - 5. If you see, 2 is the LCM, 19 - 10. Yes or no? 3d = 2 - 19 - 10. Okay, what it will be? 9/2. Now I am writing the remaining portion here, beta. See what we got. 3d = 9/2. From here, d = 9/2 × 1/3. Because this 3 will shift it towards right and it will divide the right term. Okay. This. Therefore, d is 3/2. What does it mean? Add 3/2. 3/2 means 1.5. Yes or no? Add 1.5.
6.5.
Add 1.5.
8.
Add 1.5. 9.5. It is so. Yes or no? This is the answer. So simple, beta. That's why I am saying, understand this criteria. This, make the equations and then solve this. Make the equations and then solve these. Okay. Take the screenshot. Done. Now see beta, I am going for the next question. Question number 3, part 3rd. Sorry, part 4th. How many parts this question has? 5. Okay. 4th part we have achieved. See, 4th part. -4--. One more dash. 6. 4 dashes are there, beta. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't get panic. So simple method I have told you. So simple. See, write in form of equation. Try to write all the things you have. Do not think ever. Do not ever think about the things you don't have. Always think and utilize the things you have. Here what we have, just you write, (a) - 4. And what about this? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes or no? This is 6, A6. Okay? A6. This is A6. Now see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many terms in this AP? 6. And the 6th term is 6. Last term is 6. Okay? Now can I write this? (a + 5d) = 6. Yes or no? Are you getting my point, beta? See, (a + 5d) = 6. Sure? See, (a) - 4. (a) - 4 given. From here, can I write (-4 + 5d is equal to 6. You got my point, beta? It was so simple. Just same kind of process is going on throughout the question, and that's why up to the last question you will have a good compound over this. And very frankly, this exercise is gonna be fun for you if you have understood question number 3 whole. Okay, done. See, from here 5d is equal to, if you shift this 4 towards that side, it will be 6 plus 4. From here 5d is equal to 10. From here 5d is equal to 10, yes or no? And from here d is 2, you will get d is 2, yes or no? Okay beta, now see very simply, d is 2, add 2, very simple. It was so simple, it was a fun beta. You have to start to play with the numbers. Your thought process should be very clean, that which kind of questions we are dealing with and which should be the approach. See beta, in mathematics, 3-4 kinds, many questions are there which can be done by 2-3-4 methods. But it depends on the student. What is his or her thinking? What is his approach? A right approach at the right time by the right person give the right result. Okay, so beta, now see, question number 3, you have taken the screenshot. Question number 3, last part. Question number 3, part 5th. See what is here. Here it is given that, in 5th part, here it is given that box, comma 38, box, minus 22. Do not worry, you all are now lions of AP. You all are lions of AP. You all can solve the sums very, very easily. See beta, question number 3, part 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 terms are there. And which terms are given? Second term is given 38. Am I right beta? Second, third is... term is given 38, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6th term is given minus 22, am I right? Done. See beta, simply you will get the same criteria, sorry, we will use the same criteria we have used in the earlier questions. This is A plus D, 38, this is A plus 5D, minus 22, this is second equation, this is first equation. Okay beta, now see, subtract 2 minus 1, it will help you to remove A and you will get the D. Okay, now see, A plus 5D is minus 22, A plus 5D is minus 22, and here is A plus D is 38, yes or no? A plus 5D is minus 22 and A plus D is 38, sorry. Now when you subtract, you will change the signs. Done. See, this is cancelled, yes or no? Okay, what it will be? 4D. What is this? 4D. And what is this? Add. Minus 60. This is minus 60. And from here, what will you get beta? D is minus 15. D is minus 15. It means you kept decreasing 15 to get the next term. Because D is negative, it means the AP will be decreasing AP. I will tell you after this question what is a decreasing or increasing AP. See, when you subtract 15 from this, you will get 23, yes or no? And then 15, 8. And then 15, you will get 7. Sorry, minus 7. Okay? And if you are coming this side, you have to add, you will get 53. Okay, this is the answer for question number 3, part 5th. Done. Now you take the screenshot. Okay beta, now see, we will discuss what is an increasing AP or a decreasing AP. Because beta, In last lecture, when I was introducing AP, I forgot to tell you about the increasing and decreasing. It doesn't matter, no? Right now you will need it, and it came to my mind because when we were dealing with the D and the frequency, AP, C beta. Increasing AP, decreasing AP, finite AP, sometimes this term is there, finite AP, infinite AP. See, but very simple. For infinite AP, suppose I am giving 2, 4, 6, 8 and no last term is mentioned. This is infinite AP. Here, 2, 4, 6, 8 and the last term is added, mentioned. This is finite AP. Where number of terms are given. Number of terms are not given. Infinite AP. Decreasing AP, where D is negative. Where D is negative, okay? And where D is positive. Beta C, why this is called increasing AP? Because when D is positive, the AP, the next term of the AP is always greater than the previous one. See, 5, 9, 5, 13, 17. And so, this is the example of increasing AP. This minus this is plus 4. That's why this is increasing AP. Decreasing 17, 13, 9, 5 and so on. Here you will get minus 4, this minus this. That's why this is decreasing AP. And one more you think. It was like this, it was like this. When you reverse the AP, when you reverse the AP, the sign of D is changed. When you reverse the AP, the sign of D is changed. That I used in the question number 3. Okay? Done. Now it came to my mind. That's why I told you. Now without any delay, question number 4. Question number 4. See beta, what is given here? Which term of the given AP is 78? Which term of the given AP is 78? Question number 4. 3, 8, 13, 18 and so on up to is 78. See beta, AP is given. A, D we can find. This is the term given. A last term of the AP, whatever is the number of the term, we don't know, we have to find that. AP's term is given. We have to check which term is this. Might be it is the term, this is not the term of this AP. See beta, in which class you are reading, studying, sorry. You will say, sir, 10th class. Okay. In January, in September, I will ask you which class you are studying. You will say, sir, 10th class. In November, December, January, before exam, in January, I ask in which class you are studying. You will say, sir, 10th class. Is there any criteria? You will say, sir, I am studying in 10.1 class, 10.2 class, 10.5 class, 10.75 class. Yes or no? If you are saying, I am studying in 10th class, aap ye bolenge, main 10th class mein hoon. Aap ye thodi bologe, main 10.5 class mein hoon. Main pone 10th class mein hoon. Ya minus 10th class mein hoon. Okay, you got my point. See beta, whenever the term of an AP is there, that position of its is a natural number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not 1.5, 1 by 2 or negative. Okay? Always remember the position of a term in an AP is always related that n. The position of the term is always natural number. Okay? Done. Now see, what is given here? A is 3. Yes or no? Always, what I have said you beta, whenever you are starting to solve the question, first you write all the things you have. Okay. A is 3, this minus this. D is 8 minus 3, that is 5. And this is a term, 78. You have to find N. You have to find N, which term is this? If n is a natural number, yes, this is the term and this is the term. This is the position of the term. But if n is something else other than natural number, you will say, no, it's not the term of this AP. Okay, see what happens. See beta, a plus n minus 1d is an, yes or no? We have studied this. Done, beta. Now see, what is the value of a? 3. N we don't know and d is 5 is equal to 78. Okay. What is this? N minus 1 into 5 is 78 minus 3. From here you can write 9 minus 1 into 5 is 75. Yes or no? Okay, beta. Now see, this into this is equal to this. If you shift 5 towards that, it will cancel it. N minus 1 is 15. Okay. N minus 1 will remain here. 5 will cancel it up to 15 times. Now see, from here n is equal to 15 plus 1, that is 16. And this is a, this belongs to a natural number. This belongs to a natural number. Yes, 78 is the term of this AP and its position is 16th. It means its 16th term is 78. See beta, very simple. We are using just this relation. In each and every question, we are using this relation and we are finding the desirable results. Okay, done. You can take the screenshot. Done. One more question we will do. Two, three questions we can do. We have 10 minutes, beta. 10 minutes left for this lecture. I will try my best to give you the solutions of at least two questions. Question number 5. Oh shit, 5 has two parts itself. First is 7, 13, 19, 205. See beta, what is given here in this part? This is an AP and this is the last term. Tell me how many terms are there in this AP. See beta, if I can guess its position, if I can find its position, that will automatically tell me the number of terms. Yes or no? That will automatically tell me the number of terms in this AP. Okay, see, A is here, 7. D is this minus this, 6. An is 205. And we have to find. And we have to find. Once again, beta. A plus n minus 1d is an, yes or no? A plus n minus 1d is an. Done. Put the values. A plus n minus 1 into d is an, yes or no? Yes or no? Okay, now see, n minus 1 into 6 is equal to 205 minus 7. This 7 is shifted towards right. From here you can write n minus 1 into 6, this minus this is 198, yes or no? This minus this is 198, okay? 205 minus 7, 198. See beta, n minus 1, this 6 will cancel this. 6 threes are and 6 threes are, okay? From here you will get n minus 1 is equal to 33. And then n is equal to 33 plus 1, 34. Yes or no? Where does it mean? It means this is the 30, this is the term of this AP. This is the 34th term of this AP. And number of total terms in this AP is also 34. Is also 34. Okay, beta. See, these are simple questions. Very easy and very, very fun-loving questions. That's why I'm a little bit faster and you have to be a little bit more efficient, beta. Because this exercise has so much number of questions. And we have to complete these on the time. Okay, done. Now see, next question, you take the screenshot. Now question number 5, part 2nd. It was part 1st, beta. See, part 2nd. What is given here? What is given here? Again an AP is given. And we have to find number of terms. 18, 15 half, 13 and so on up to minus 47. See beta, This is a decreasing AP. Yes or no? D will be negative. Okay. Now see. Here A is 18. D is 15 and a half. And this is 13. 2.5. 5 by 2 is subtracted. Beta, if you understand this, okay. Otherwise, subtract this from this or this. I like you to make the calculation in your brain. Okay. What do I do? See, beta, main apni language mein kaam karta hu calculations pe. Main kya karu? Galat ho jaye kabhi kuch tumhare tarike se karta ho jata hai. Main kya lagata hu mera dimag mein. ये साढ़े पंद्रह ये तेरह से तेरह में ढाई जोड़ा तो साढ़े तेरह तेरह में ढाई जोड़ेंगे तो साढ़े पंद्रह आएगा सॉरी है ना तेरह में ढाई जोड़ा तो साढ़े पंद्रह आया साढ़े पंद्रह से ढाई घटाया तो ये आया इट्स डन ओके आई यूज वेरी फ्रेंकली सी बेटा कैलकुलेशंस कैन बी मेड फर्स्ट ओनली इन द केस यू डू द कैलकुलेशन इन यूअर ओन लैंग्वेज In the language you think. In the language you think. See, beta, I am from Haryana and my background was in totally Hindi medium. That's why when I was a student, I started to learn the calculations. I used these methods. I used my own mother tongue. But whenever I am calculating in my mind, no one can hear my mind. Output is on the written paper is matter. Better yes or no? Okay, that's why make the calculation in my language, whichever you think, in which you think. It can be Hindi, it can be English, it can be your local language, but only in mind to make the calculations easy. Okay, okay, otherwise you have to withstand the world, with the global world. Okay, so use your language. With mouth, according to the decorum of your school, your parents, your society. Okay, done, beta. Now see, question number 5, part 2. I will say D is minus 5 by 2 because this minus this will give me minus 5 by 2. Okay, then last term is given minus 47 and n we have to find. And we have to find. Okay, beta. Now see, what is the formula for an? An. You remember a plus n minus 1d is equal to an. A plus n minus 1d is an. A is 18. N minus 1. D is minus 5 by 2. A is minus 47. A is minus 47. Now see, beta. N minus 1. Into minus 5 by 2 is equal to here is minus 47 shift this toward this minus 18 from here n minus 1 into minus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 65 now see beta these are into multiplication it when you will shift this it will change itself, yes or no? From here, n minus 1 is equal to, here is minus 65. Minus 5 by 2 will become minus 2 by 5. Okay? Now minus, minus, plus, it will cancel 13. N minus 1 is 13, 2s are 26. Therefore, you will get n is equal to 27. You will get n is equal to 27 is the answer. Okay, beta. See, what we did in this lecture, beta, we solved 5 questions of exercise 5.2. 5 questions of exercise 5.2 and tomorrow we will submit. Sum up it. Clear the exercise 5.2. See, it took so much time for 5 questions because, beta, each and every question was given with some parts. First was 3, second 2, third 6, fifth 5 parts. In this one way, we could be able to solve only 5 questions today. But from the next, in the next lecture, we have one question, one part. That's why in that case we will be able to clear all the exercise. We will complete the exercise 5.2 tomorrow. Okay, done beta. Okay, have a nice day. Stay safe, stay home. And one more thing, please beta, like, share and give positive comments to the video. At least 600 to 700 students are there in class 9. One of my friends yesterday told me, Rajiv, how many students you have in your class in 10th? I said, near about 600. And what are the timings for your class? I told him 11 to 12 right now. He told very frankly, only 60-65 students was the lecture during that class time 11 to 12. It was very, very, very shattering, beta. I was shocked. Why students are not watching the lecture regularly? The teachers are doing so much hard work for you, beta. Please, please, Princeans, be regular, be attentive. Otherwise, if the time is gone, you will regret, beta. You will regret. This is your board class. No one can help you if you are not ready to help yourself. No one can help you, beta, if you are not ready to help yourself. We, the teachers, are doing our best. Whole Prince team is trying to give our best in this lockdown. But you are not taking the chance as opportunity. It means it's your fault. Okay? See, beta, please be Princeans. Okay? Be regular, be attentive. And please, one more thing, like, share and give positive comments on the video. Have a nice day. Done by myself.